The first tale of Shadowgate concluded with the evil warlock lord battling the young hero atop the Well of Souls far beneath Castle Shadowgate. The warlock lord had summoned a being, the behemoth from the Netherworlds, and with this creature under his power, he planned to conquer the world. But with a blast from the fabled Staff of Ages, the young hero broke the warlock lord's control over the beast. The behemoth turned on its former master, and the warlock lord was dragged down into the Netherworld by the very creature he sought to control. The young hero, now king of the land, realized that the power within Shadowgate would always tempt those who would use its magic for evil. So he became the first of a dynasty, the Line of Kings, who took it as their mandate to keep safe the power of Shadowgate. The second tale of Castle Shadowgate is that of Prince Eric, distant descendant of the young hero, whose father now protects Shadowgate. Prince Eric has for many years traveled abroad, gaining wisdom in preparation for the day when he assumes his father's role. But now, in his 18th year, a message from his distant homeland reaches Eric. It is from his father's new advisor, Balazar, and it bears grim news. My liege, it is with great sadness that I inform you that your father, King Erend, has been murdered. While your troops search the land for his assassin, you must return home and assume your rightful place on the throne. As his ship steers a course towards Cal Tordon's shores, Eric's thoughts are of the family he left behind when his journeys began. He remembers his country, Cal Tordon, a land of great beauty, as well as potential danger. He remembers fondly his father, King Erend, whose wisdom and kindness has guided Cal Tordon for 30 years. And perhaps, most fondly of all, he remembers his younger sister, Elizabeth. At last, Eric reaches Cal Tordon, his birthplace, and now, his kingdom. His grief over his father's death is all but forgotten when he sees how his beloved sister has grown in his absence. Eric is introduced to Balazar, his father's advisor. While Balazar seems charming and intelligent, Eric still feels a strange unease about him. With a shrug, Eric dismisses his odd apprehension, and they begin to discuss Eric's coronation. But suddenly, two soldiers seize Prince Eric.
The assassin has been captured,
they claim.
And the villain says he was hired by Prince Eric himself.
Couldn't wait to seize the throne, eh, Prince?
Shouts Balazar as they drag the bewildered prince to the dungeons.
You'll wear no crown without a head.
And this is how Eric's greatest adventure and the second tale of Shadowgate begins.
Get in there, you scum!
Oh, Eric!
Elizabeth!
I know you are innocent, my brother. Something evil has befallen the kingdom, and I don't trust Balazar. I keep thinking of poor father.
I'll have to find a way out of here. As the last of the line of kings, I'll avenge father's death, I swear!
Thank you.
my son. There is more to the events of the last few weeks than the murder of a king and false arrest of his heir. There looms a far greater threat, which you must ultimately face within the walls of Shadowgate. I will be with you when I can.
You're free to go. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excuse me? Hello?
Where am I? Oh, who are you? How did you get here? By the bridge? Then you must have the crank they took from me. Have you the crank? If you will give it to me, I have something for you. I've given you a foreign language phrase book. If you meet someone you can't understand, try looking in this book for the words you need. I'm so glad you happened upon me here. I prefer to live alone, but I do need to get out now and again to dig for roots or collect wyvern eggs. Yes, yes, I'm a happy hermit now.
Well, I'll be going now. Thank you for the phrase book.
and country. Farewell, friends 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 and country. Thank you.
Virilissimo servizio magnanimo et mucho gratuosimo.
Well, let's see. Young man, you have done us a great service today, and we are very grateful.
Demonico meloro, executio villaggio, si existo iuo.
These evil demons would have killed us all had it not been for you.
Meoro gifto, magico pipo, sumino spirito, approximo verdo.
I'm giving you some enchanted pipes which you can use to call the fairies in the druid wood.
Son, Balazar has taken Elizabeth out of the city, and even now he boasts to her of his evil plans for her. Although he hasn't harmed her yet, I fear this will change when they reach their destination. Through her thoughts I see a deep forest and a mountain range beyond. Hurry, my son. I will continue to try to reach her and will tell you when I know more.
Stop, sentries! Let him pass. When I was chained in the castle dungeons, he set me free. Were it not for him, I would be dead. He is Eric, son of King Erond. We must help him!
Iphicles, king of the fairies. I have been watching your progress for some time. What is it that you seek?
I seek the evil Belazar and my sister, whom I believe he has taken captive.
Ah, I can help you if you help me first. My daughter, Princess Alessandra, is also in great danger. A goblin shaman has captured her and holds her in his temple in the woods. I am powerless against the shaman. I need the help of a brave young mortal.
I'll do what I can.
Thank you. You dare interrupt my private ceremonies? You dare threaten the shaman? You will die a slow death, and the young Alessandra can watch!
Daughter!
Father!
I am in your debt. I will send you